and walk home. 2 weeks later, I got her phone number, asked her out one day. 2 weeks later, I asked her to marry me. Next August, we married for 40 years.
Amen.
That was the best thing that ever happened to me, was meeting Robin Gale Mann. Because see, after we got married, I looked and I thought, that right there is what a Christian needs to act like. I'm not acting like that. So what I'm trying to say is, ladies, God can use you to reach your husband who is lost, to show your husband, if he's a Christian, the sin that he's having in his life, if you are a godly woman.
Amen.
That's what that verse is saying. Amen?
Amen.
So that they may be won over without words by the behavior of their wives. Are you a dictator? Or are you a sweet taker? Let's look at the next table. Imitator. Got the same kind of hat on for mama, but wants to look like her mom. Wants to be like her mom. You know what, kids? It's okay for you to want to be like mom and dad, but you need to imitate the Jesus that you see inside of them. You see, parents, that's why it's so important for us to get up every day and put on our armor, to pray, to cleanse ourselves by the word of the Lord. It's so important to do that so our kids can see the love of Jesus in us. Amen?
Amen.
Imitator. Emma was a Christian, but she wanted to be like everyone else. She was not happy to be herself because she came from a poor family. She wanted to be like all, wanted to be liked by all, so she didn't act like herself. The Bible says this: be imitators of God, therefore, as dearly beloved children, and live a life of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. If you're going to imitate anybody, imitate Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Don't try to be something you're not just to make friends, kids, or to be popular. You want to be like Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
We'll put Emma back in here. We're going to give her away after a while. Oh, here's one. Y'all ready for this? Spectator. You know, spectator. Now, spectator was also the Christian, but he didn't want to get involved with the children's ministry or youth group at church. He didn't think that was cool, and he didn't want to take the time to go to choir practice or go on mission trips. He was lazy, and he wanted to kick back and take it easy. Listen, folks, I'm going to be honest with you. That's where most of our church members are, Pastor. They come to church, and they want to spectate. They want to sit there and soak it all in. And as long as you soak it in and never do nothing, guess what? You're going to sour. You're going to sour. You got to get off your blessed assurance, folks, and start doing something for the Lord. Amen? God doesn't want us to be a spectator. He wants us to get in the ball game. He wants us to get on the field. He wants us to participate. Here's what the Bible says. Listen now. Luke 13:23 says this: then the master told his servants, go out to the road of the country lanes and compel them to come in so that my house will be full. Now, we've got a good crowd here tonight. But that word compel, you know what that means? It means to beg. Go out and beg people to come out the door. Please come and see that crazy man get inside the balloon. Please come and watch him eat fire. Well, why didn't we do that? Because I want you to come to know Jesus.
Yeah, amen.
Folks, there is a method to my madness, ain't it? I just don't eat fire for the fun of it. Everything I do points people to Jesus.
Amen.
That's why I do it. So, are you a spectator? Are you sitting out there, sitting, soaking, and souring? Oh, you're going to like this one. Heart tater, look at it. That boy is ticked off. Now, heart tater was a Christian but had a bad temper. He got mad to come for hat. He was always fighting and fussing with someone, especially with his twin sister. That was me. Listen, when I was at Pepsi-Cola, a Christian man, I had a man take a score away from me. He went in and talked to the ball and stole a store away from me. That was taking money out of my family's mouth. That beat me off. And I was going to deal with it. And I went in one day and I said, Don, what you did was wrong. And he looked at me and he said, well, I tell you what. It's been a long time since I've been in the big fight, the big fight. I reached over, I grabbed me a glass. I broke it on the edge of the desk and I said, I'll cut you from one end to the next. A Christian man doing that. I blew it, boy. I messed up. But you know what? God is so compassionate. He took me to the woodshed, tore me up.
Amen.
I went back to that man the very next day and said, Don, I'm a Christian man. And I threatened to cut you yesterday because I got mad at you. And I'm asking you right now, brother, to forgive me for that. I am sorry. That man wound up years later, after I got on staff at the church there, coming to that church because me and him were buddies. Listen, guys. Hot take. Are you like that? One more voice again. Colossians 3:8 said this. But now you must get rid of all anger, rage, malice, slander, and dirty language from your lips. Y'all hear that? Dirty language. That means those little jokes we tell it at jobs. That kind of off-color joke. That we think's okay, but God don't. God don't. You see, what you gotta do is this, folks. You gotta get to the point in your life where the Lord is the master of your eyes, the master of your mind, the master of your ears, the master of your mouth, the master of your thoughts, and your attitude. That's what you got to do. And the only way you do that is by surrendering, by being cleansed. And the Lord can do that for you tonight. Amen? So, are you a dictator, a sweet tater, imitator, spectator, or a hot tater? What has the Lord showed? What has the Lord showed us tonight? Here's the next one. This one got a little ponytail, look. Oh, look at her, y'all. This one here is agitator. Agitator is that young lady who always picks on people, who always has a plan when they go to school or church to rub somebody the wrong way. Do y'all know people like that? You may be one of them. Agitators. The Bible says this in Proverbs 26:20. Without wood, a fire goes out. Without gossip, a quarrel dies down. One thing that is destroying our churches, ladies and gentlemen, is gossip. It's gossip. Talking about the preacher. Talking about the preacher's wife. Talking about the music. Talking about the sermon they didn't like, and most of the time they didn't like it is the reason because the Lord slapped them in the face. Amen? He convicted them about something. Listen, that little thing called our tongue does more damage than anything. As a matter of fact, that little thing in our mouth called our tongue is the most powerful weapon in the world. The most powerful weapon in the world. Encouraging words, words that build people up, is what we as Christians need to do. Amen?
Amen?
That's what we need to do. So, without wood, the fire goes out, without gossip, the quarrel dies down. All right, here's the next one. Figure this one, y'all. Got a little butterfly on the hat. This one here is hesitator. Hesitator. You know, some of y'all hesitated this morning. You got right with the Lord. We had an invitation. And I said, as soon as that young lady started starts to sing, y'all come. Now, here's what impressed me. Well, a lot of people started coming before she started singing. Amen?
Amen.
But some of you sit back there and you hesitate. You thought about it. You thought about it. Now, parents, let me ask y'all something. When you were raising your kids, and you told your kids to do something, little boy, and they hesitated, what happened? Well, I tell you what happened at my house. They got their behind busted. They got their behind busted. Now, folks, listen to me. If we, as adults, want our kids to do exactly what we want to do without hesitation, don't you think God the Father wants the same thing from us as children? Hesitation. The Bible says in this, in 6:1-3, Ephesians 6:1-3, kids, listen, children, obey your parents and Lord, for this is the right. Parents, listen. You're a child of God. Children, obey the Lord, for that's right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment of the Father, that it may go well with you, and that you may enjoy long life on the earth. So, you are to obey without hesitation. Amen? Yeah. You ready for this? Oh, my favorite. Fried tater. See the fried tater? You got the mohawk. That's my goatee. You got the earring. You got the nose and earring. He's a rebellious one, man. I don't know if Fried Tater was a Christian or not. Fried was the oldest boy in the Tater family. He got involved with a bunch of boys when he was in high school. And he began to smoke dope and drink beer. He was drunk all the time or high. As a matter of fact, he smoked dope so much that it fried his brain. I have been around guys that I played football with in college who done marijuana all the time. And they got to the point that they couldn't even think what they were doing. I remember, brother, lining up over the ball in a big football game. Had my hand on that football. And one of those guys who played right off in the guard lined up by me. And he looked at me and said, Peaches, call me Peaches. He said, Peaches, who do I block? And there was a man right in front of him. He was so high. His brain had been so burnt that he didn't even know who to block. And two of those boys on that football team were smoking marijuana one day, driving down the road, higher than a kite, in an orange Volkswagen, in the middle of the road, and a farm truck hit them head on, crippled them for life. And they lost everything. They lost their scholarships. They lost everything. Listen, Fried Tater. The Bible says this, teenagers, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, instead be filled with the Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
You want to get high on Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, here's a good one. Mash Tater. Now, Mash was the oldest girl. And she was always mashing and bashing someone with the words that came out of her mouth. Oh, we get that? We talked about gossip a while ago. But I'm going to tell you, gossip will destroy a relationship. It'll destroy a church. Now, I can come over here to Chris, and I can whisper something juicy about Brother Dale in his ears, and Chris hears it, and I know what I said. Brother Dale don't know what I said. But God knows. God even hears a whisper. Don't need to understand that. He hears all and he sees all. The Bible says this. With the tongue we praise our Lord and Father. Who has done that tonight? Amazing grace. We praise God the Father. And with it, we curse men. Who has been made in God's likeness. Out of the same mouth come praise and cursing, the Bible says. My brothers, this should not be. So, what is the Lord showing you about you tonight? Don't be nudging your neighbor and saying, that's him. The next one, is, look at this one, y'all. Coltator. Coltator. Coltator is that person who comes to church and they give the cold shoulder to other people. They're not very friendly. They're not very kind. When the preacher says, get up and go welcome others, they sit there on their blessed assurance. As a matter of fact, some of those people who are so cold, they have their chairs picked out in the church, and God forbid if you get in. When I was on staff and I went to the adult church services, I always looked at people like that and I went and got their chair. What did they beat me up? The Bible says this. We should examine ourselves daily to see if we're in the faith. As we do this, we should ask God to show us our ungodly attitude that we might have toward others. We should also ask Him to help us become more like Him daily. And then the reason why. Here's the reason why. Because the little tater tots, the little tater tots in the nursery, they're watching. Listen, adults. Y'all come in here and get nasty in a business meeting. I don't know if you have business meetings. But if you have business meetings and you get nasty, you got to remember, those little tater tots in there, they're seeing it. And they're hearing it. If you're a dictator, husbands, and you treat your wife like she's the queen of church, and then you go home and you treat her like scum, you got to remember, the little tater tots are seeing it. You come to church and you want to be a spectator. You don't want to get off your blessed assurance and do nothing. You just want to come and sit and soak and take it all in. Just remember, the little tater tots are watching. You want to be an agitator. You want to keep things stirred up. So remember, the little tater tots are seeing. Everything we've talked about tonight, people, is your little kid, your tater tots are seeing it. And the thing is, God sees it too. So, what has the Lord showed you about you? Are you a dictator? Or are you a sweet tater? Sweet tater was that way because she spent time alone the Lord daily. Are you an imitator? A spectator? A hot tater? An agitator? A hesitator? A fried tater? I hope not. A mass tater or a cold tater? Which one are you? Whatever God has showed you tonight, whatever attitude you might have, you need to get rid of it. Because, see, tomorrow night, we're going to start our salvation messages. And we're going to hope and trust that tomorrow night, you bring people that don't know Jesus. And we're hoping and trusting that tomorrow night, because we have been unchained, we've been set free, because we've confessed our sin, and the Lord's done His part, and He's cleansed us, that we are not going to quench the work of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yeah. So if you would just bow your head and look at it. Let me ask you something. Honesty. You're a good trait. You've got to be honest with yourself. Remember, when revival takes place, one of the things we've got to do is be honest with us. As we were talking about all these silly taters tonight, did God show you which one you were? If God showed you that you were one of those taters, that you need to work on a certain area of your life, would you just raise your hand? Put them up high. So I assume that all of y'all, the rest of you, don't have no problems.
I'm there, Mom.
Folks, every time I do potato famine, God continues to remind me what I am. I can see myself in these taters tonight. And as long as I can see myself, there's help for me, amen? So you're sitting here tonight, and God has showed you something that you need to get rid of in your life. Very quietly. I just want you to pray and tell God what it is right now. I want you to tell God that you're sorry for allowing that to remain in your life. And I want you to ask Him to forgive you for not being a godly Christian, a godly example of what you should at home and out in the community. And then I want you to thank God for forgiving you of that sin in your life tonight. Thank God that He sent His Son to die on the cross for you. That He was buried. And on the third day He came out. Thank God that He is in heaven right now praying for us. And thank God that He doesn't give up on us. Now let me ask God another question. You're here tonight and you know beyond a shadow of a doubt you're going to heaven. Would you just raise your hand? You know for sure. There's no doubt in your mind. Put them down. Now there were a few that couldn't raise their hand. And we want to give them an opportunity to accept the Lord. Amen? Amen. The Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. We're going to die one day. When we die, we're going to go to a place called heaven or hell. You don't got to go to a place called hell, folks, because of what Jesus done for you on the cross of Calvary. If you will only say a prayer, asking the Lord to forgive you of your sins, asking Him to come into your heart to be your Lord and Savior, He will save you. Yeah. Scripture says in Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what you've done. It doesn't matter what you think. God will save you if you'll ask Him to. Amen?
Amen.
You say, Bub, there's been so much things many things I've done, I can't remember all my sin. Well, the Lord does. The Lord does. He'll forgive you for even the things you've forgotten. Amen? So you're sitting out there and you've never accepted the Lord, but you don't know how to accept the Lord. Let me help you with that. If you want to accept the Lord tonight, and to your heart as Lord and Savior, why don't you say this prayer with me to yourself? Dear Jesus, I am a sinner. And I know I need you. Jesus, I know that you're the way to heaven. You're the only way. Tonight, dear Jesus, I'm asking you to forgive me of my sins. The sins that I remember and the sins that I do not remember.
Yes.
And right now, dear Jesus, I'm asking you to come into my heart to be your Lord and Savior. Tonight, dear Lord, the best way I know how, I am going to make you the boss of my life. Thank you, dear Jesus, for saving me. Let me ask you a question. If you said that prayer with me just a second ago, asking Jesus Christ into your heart for the very first time, would you just very quietly raise your hand? I'm not going to come to you. Just raise your hand up. I see. Put them down. Now what we're going to do in a minute, when this young lady starts singing, those of you that raise your hand getting saved, we're going to ask that you'll come forward, take Brother Dale or Brother Leroy or one of these ladies by the hand, and just let them talk to you about what you've done. Amen? If you're here tonight and you just want to come up or get on your knees there by your chair, and pray for revival tomorrow night, you can do that. That's okay, amen. So as everybody stand, and as soon as she starts to sing, those of you that raise your hand, accepting Jesus, y'all come forward, if you would. If you would. You got men and women up here. You ready, young lady? Go ahead. Y'all come on. Say that prayer, accepting Jesus. Come on down. Anybody? You got some kids coming. Always good, that's me and John.
much for the chance to be reminded tonight how we live and to serve and to be the way that you have called us to live, just like Jesus. Help us, Lord, as we get ready to go from this place, that we would follow after your steps. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
May you be seated. Paul. Paul came tonight. So Paul, up to you. Paul is a brand new believer in Jesus. About what comes next, and baptism, and church membership, and a chance to learn to be discipled like Jesus. So that's going to be exciting. And so that's good. And others came so they could have prayer, so they could get God's help.
Little Chuck's came and asked Jesus to be his Lord and Savior. He's sitting there with Mom.
There you go. Yeah. So here's the challenge. Do you remember my 316? Do you? There was a little homework, right? You remember what that homework was? Three people. That we were praying for three people in our life, people we know, so that God might provide a chance for us to tell them about Jesus. But we're to pray, keep praying for those three people until they get saved. How many of you still got your list of three people? Okay, there's a few of them. That's good. And if you don't have that list, start one now. Think of three people that you could call tomorrow. Maybe somebody at work, maybe an next-door neighbor. Think of three people. Think of their names right now. Start thinking. Get their name in your head. They're Bill, and they're George, and there's Anita. And get their name in your head. Now let's ask God to give us a chance to get a hold of them. By the phone, over their house, before the night's over, or tomorrow at work, or lunchtime, you call and invite that person to come tomorrow night and to hear what God's going to say through Bubba. And tell them what Bubba said. You know, hey, we got this weird guy who's going to eat fire. And he's going to do a bunch of other stuff. And it'll be fun. It'll be exciting. But also, he's going to tell about real important things to do with our life. And so why don't you come with me tomorrow night? By the way, that means you're coming tomorrow night, right?
Yes.
Amen. That was kind of weak. I'd really like to know that most of you, if not every one of you, is going to come back tomorrow night.
Yes.
And there's some of you who are going to be challenged, but let me tell you what, I think you're up to the challenge. Because if God's going to do something special, I like what Paul said. He said, this feels so good. But it's not about the feelings, though. But when God does help us to feel good, that's a blessing alongside of what God has just done, what God promised. And so let me encourage you to find somebody. How many of you would take that challenge and call one, if not all three of those people, sometime between now and tomorrow afternoon? Okay, that's good. That's a good response. Everybody's been cool. Jerry, we can set up extra chairs if we need to, right?
Amen.
Amen. He's always supposed to say yes, so he did, just in case you hear it. All right. Well, we get a chance now to give a love offering to Brother Bubba. And I want you to, as we get ready to pause, actually, you know what I said? I said we're going to pray about it, right? Didn't I say we're going to pray about those three people and about it?
Right.
Let's stop and do that first, okay? Let's bow our heads together. Lord Jesus, we come asking right now that the front lines be open for us to call our friend, our neighbor, the people we work with. Or tomorrow morning, our neighbor will be leaving the house same time as we do. Or that we'll run into that person that we've been praying for at the grocery store or at work. Lord, put that person in our path, or put us in their path, and help us to call them and invite them to come tomorrow night to hear your word. Lord, we know, and this is what we pray, that your word would come so fresh and so powerful that our friends, if they just are here so they can listen to your word, they'll be changed.
Right.
And Lord, it may be more than friends. It may be somebody in our family that we love dearly, and we want to make sure that they're going to heaven with us. So Lord, help us to make that phone call. And Lord, when we don't know what to say, help us with the words. And Lord, I remember what you told Paul, that he'd get the words just when he needed them. So Lord, help us not to be afraid to dial that number and to know that you'll give us words at just that moment that we need them.
Right.
But Lord, help us to be bold, help us to be courageous with our faith, to call that person that we were just thinking of, and we had their name in our head, help us, Lord, not to get distracted tonight on the way home or tomorrow at work. Help us to remember, whether it's at our break time or our lunch, help us to remember, whether it's wherever we're going, to look for that person and to look for a chance to invite them tomorrow night. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. That's going to be fun.
Amen.
Brother Bubba does this. I mentioned it. And he's different than most evangelists. Wouldn't you agree? Okay. How many of you know an evangelist? Oh, okay. A few of you. How many of you know he's weirder than most of you ever met? Amen. That's good. That's because you're unique and you're different. The Bible says that's what we're going to be, is unique and different. I want to support Brother Bubba's ministry. I love what he does when we bring him here to our church. I'd love to know he gets to do that to a whole bunch of other churches because we support what he's doing. And so let me ask you to pray a very simple prayer. In a moment, I'm going to have our ushers come up. And I'm going to ask that we just pray, each one of us individually, pray a very simple prayer. Lord, what do you want me to give? And then let God speak to your heart, and then you obey, you give whatever it is that God impresses on your heart to give. Now tonight, if you brought your tithe or offering for the church, for the work that the Lord does in our church, I want you to write on an envelope, tithe or offering, and put it in an envelope. And then all the money in the offering plate and everything like that that people put in, we're going to trust that you're giving that to as a love offering to Brother Bubba. And that will help his ministry and help him take care of his family and help him to be a blessing to those folks that he gets to go to next.
And remind them that they have to take their tithes and give it to the love offering.
Okay.
To the church.
I should remind them of what you just said. Okay. Did y'all hear what he just said?
Yeah.
Okay, so our tithes don't go to Bubba's Adventure.
Right.
Our tithes go into the offering plate in an envelope marked tithe for tonight, if that's what you're giving it. And that's going to be going into the church for our budget, for us to reach out to the lost, for us to do the kind of things we do to minister and disciple God's people. So mark that as a tithe, and the rest of it we'll give to Bubba's Adventure and see what God does. Can I have four guys to help receive the offering? And there we go.
Come on.
We got.
Okay.
Okay. And so let's pray. Ask God's blessing over the gift, over all that give, and ask that God uses this offering for his glory. So let's bow together. Let's pray. Gary, lead us as we pray. Father God, we just want to consider the things we've been talking about. We pray, Father God, that whatever is hindering us in our walk with you, Lord God, that you would clear those things from our heart. Lord, help us to change our minds and change our hearts so that we would glorify you, that we would walk and live according to your will. Father God, as we give, we pray that we would give from the heart, that, Lord God, that your name would be able to reach the your name will reach out to the community, that Father God, that people will hear your word, that Father, that they would come to know you as Savior, because that's the important part of this life, is knowing Jesus as our Savior. So, Lord God, just bless this offering, and we thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you.
serve up some cake. Is that right, cake?
Yes,
cake. And you can enjoy that, and we'll fellowship, and we'll just have a little bit of time. If you want to go home so you can make those phone calls, do that. Pray for Paul. You know how the devil will try to get him, but you also know how exciting it is when we first trust in the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
And so let me encourage you, tomorrow night we're going to come back at
6:30.
Everybody got it? 6:30? All right. God bless you. We're dismissed. Have a great